Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. My name is Bilal Abdul Karim for OGN Maps. Today, we're going to discuss the swirling controversy that is taking place in the United Nations Security Council. They've been discussing over the past few days, and actually for the past 6 months, the entrance of aid into Syria. Now, aid has been coming from the United Nations since 2014, and it's been servicing the needs of millions of Syrians which are in need of food assistance since 2014, and it is vitally important that it continues. They did decide that it will be allowed to continue for another year, but there was a great deal of controversy surrounding it. Both Russia and China were vetoing. They actually vetoed 8 different proposals in terms of the aid coming in, and on the 9th one, they decided to abstain. Let's go to the map and let's take a look and see what things have been looking like over here in terms of ports. Look here to the south. This is Dara. That's an area, a port that's called Ramtha. Now let's look here to the northeast up here. You'll see another port which is on the border of Iraq, which is called Yarubiya. These two ports were closed earlier this year. Now let's big up this map and let's take a look at the areas right over here. Now you've got the right over here, the Bab al-Salam port. That port was decided it will be closed just yesterday, leaving only one area open, and that area is right here, which is called Bab al-Hawa. Bab al-Hawa will remain open and will receive the aid for the millions of Syrians which are in the immediate area right around Bab al-Hawa area, but it's not as efficient as if the Bab al-Salam port was to remain open. But that's just the reality of the situation. At the end of the day, Russia wanted all of the aid to go through Damascus. However, Bashar al-Assad has used food as a tool for war to starve its populations and to whip them into submission. We'll be following this up as it develops. I am Bilal Abdul Karim. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.